You tell us about the work you've done in like in the orphanage, which is obviously in Kenya.
Yes, yeah. Well, after school, it was I went over on a gap year, and I was working in a St. Stephen's orphanage. And unfortunately, towards the end of my trip, the landlord of that place told the Kenyan woman who was running it that because he had Westerners working, volunteering there, he was putting up the rent. And I was, I'd only just left school and the woman told me this, and I kind of felt like saying, well, what do you expect me to do about it? I've raised all my money to come here and I don't have any more. But for me to even be there, I've probably got more money than I'll ever have, having afforded the plane ticket. But she left, she walked away from the kids, and they were effectively abandoned for the second, third, maybe fourth time in their lives. And I just couldn't have that on my conscience. So I came home, tried to raise funds, totally supported by my local community and raising those funds. We wouldn't be where we are today without them. And I just carried on backwards and forwards, building it bit by bit. And in 2012, we opened it to our first 8 kids, and it's just grown arms and legs. We've got 20 kids and 6 staff now, with more exciting plans for the future.
Absolutely fantastic. And obviously winning this award tonight, just raising the profile even
well,
more.
Yeah, that's great. Well, I was saying before tonight, if people are doing genuine good, nobody can be better at anybody else at doing genuine good. But the one thing is, hopefully it'll raise publicity, maybe get an extra couple of sponsors so that we can start tackling the waiting list we've got, and just continue with the project.
Absolutely.